Hey everyone, I'm Siddhant. I am a TypeScript engineer at Prisma, and I work on Studio, which is a database UI that ships with the Prisma CLI. So Studio is really a visual editor for your database, which means it lets you view or change your data. And like I said before, it ships for free with the Prisma CLI. So today I'm kind of hoping to show you how Studio might fit into your development workflow and how you can use it alongside other Prisma tools like Prisma Client, for example. So I've set up a little project slash example for this talk. And for the next few minutes, I want you to assume that I'm building an app that that shows you information about an NPM package given its name. So this metadata is also scraped from the NPM website because for some reason I decided that that was the best way to do it. And I decided to store all this data in a Postgres database. So that's kind of what you see here. So this is the Prisma schema that's powering the entire app, so to speak. And we have three tables here. The first one is called package. It stores information about a single package. There's another table called user, which stores information about a user. And then there's a third one called version, which stores information about a version of a package at a given point in time. So let's say the first thing that we want to do is take a look at our data, try to understand it a little bit, and try to explore it a little bit. So the usual way that you would do this would be basically there are two ways that you could have done this. You could write a script that pre-prints all of your data onto your terminal, or you could kind of open this database up in a third-party database tool, for example. But there's actually a third way, and in my opinion, a much easier way to do this is to open your database up in Prisma Studio. So Prisma Studio is kind of aware that there is something called a Prisma schema that you see here. So you don't really have to give it a database URL or anything like that. All you really need to do is go to your project and type in npx Prisma Studio, and that's about it. For the time being, Studio is considered experimental, so you also have to provide an experimental flag here, but that's going to go away very soon. So I'm going to press enter, and there we go, Studio is ready. So I'm going to switch to my browser and open Studio up. So right away, you'll see that there's a whole bunch of data in my database because I kind of seeded it beforehand. And if you go onto the left side here, you'll see that there are three models here. So you have package, user, and version. And you'll see that these directly correspond to the models that you defined in your schema, which in turn directly correspond to the tables in your database. So you can kind of think of these three as the tables in your database, which they actually are. So what you can do then is kind of take a look at this data, you scroll around a little bit. You can open two of them at the same time in two separate tabs, like I've done here. You can scroll around a bit. Okay, so this user table has this email, name, and packages. You can also open up the version table, and there's a whole bunch of data in here. So this is kind of like a very easy way and a very quick way to kind of get to your data as soon as possible. So let's assume that for the purposes of this example, I have discovered that there's a bug in my scraper, the scraper that scrapes the NPM website. And I've realized that there is a particular row of the Svelte package that has its SHA, which is this row right here, parsed incorrectly. So let's say what we want to do is we're going to find this row and we're going to try and manually fix it. So right away, you'll see that there's a whole bunch of data in here. If you go over here, you'll see that there's actually 30,000 rows in here. So we need a way to kind of reduce the number of rows in here. So what I'm going to do is apply a filter. So if you go over here and click on filter, you can click on add filter. Now, this filter is actually almost exactly the same as the Prisma client's where argument that you're used to. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a filter. I'm going to change this ID to say that the ID contains the word Svelte. Why Svelte? It's only because this is an example. Let's just assume that Svelte is the package that is incorrect. So right away, you'll see that we added a filter, and straight away, the number of rows has reduced down quite a bit. Basically, it's only showing rows that this filter kind of holds true for. But there's still like a whole bunch of rows in here. So let's also assume that I somehow magically also know that the package that we are trying to look for has its created at greater than this specific date that I have in my clipboard. So the exact data doesn't really matter. What really matters is that we are able to kind of dig into our data and figure out what row we're looking for. Let's also assume that I'm not really interested in the package name or the package columns, and so I'm just going to hide them, and even the name, if I'm being honest. So right away, you'll see that this is a reduced view of your entire database. When I say that this is Prisma client, it actually exactly is Prisma client. So what you can do is you can go into this little button here, click on it, and go to the code mode. And right away, you'll see that this is the actual Prisma client query that will yield the same result. So if you kind of copy this query over, paste it in another script, you will see that the same exact data is returned. Now, this also works the other way around. So for example, if you have a buggy query that does not return exactly what you think it does, you can kind of copy it over and paste it back in here and see what data it returns. So it's basically a much faster way. It's a much faster feedback loop, I suppose. So now I'm going to switch back to the filters though, and we'll see that this is probably the data that we want to kind of change. So this is, let's say this is the shard that was incorrectly scripted. So what you can do is kind of double click on it to enter this edit mode, and let's change this to SHA-512 changed. Let's assume that this is like a valid SHA, for example. I'm going to hit enter to apply these changes. So while we're here, I also do not like that there is apparently some sort of sentience going on in my scraper. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this row, and I'm going to go ahead and delete this record as well, just because. You'll see that your changes are not yet applied to your database. They're still kind of in this pending state, like you see here on the bottom left. This is kind of a buffer in a way to kind of prevent accidental changes or whatever. But what you really need to do to apply these changes to your database is press save changes on the bottom right. And there we go. So these changes were applied to your database. You see that this extra row was gone and that this data was actually changed. So that's kind of all I had time for today. There's a bunch of other things you can do as well, like changing rows, changing relations, and all kinds of stuff. I'm just going to close all of this. So all of this you can do without having to set up a script or anything like that. So it's basically a really quick way to get to your data. So hopefully that proves to be useful for everyone watching. If you have any questions, feel free to drop them in our public Slack, and we'll try to answer them. And yeah, thanks for watching. Enjoy the rest of your day.